Good morning, children. Today we are going to discuss the third sample question paper from class 10 science. The code of this question paper is 086. There are 36 questions, out of which around 28 to 30 mark questions are asking in the board examination. 28 to 30 mark questions are being asked in the biology section out of 70 mark. Sorry, 8 out of 80 mark. Okay. And today we are going to discuss the third sample paper of science. Okay. You have to write here science. Okay. The first question, write 2 points or differences between respiration in plants and respiration in animals. Of course, we can understand that respiration in plants. In plants, respiration takes place throughout the body, throughout the plants. All parts of the plants can perform respiration, no respiratory organ as such in plants. The gaseous exchange takes place through stomata, whereas in animals, respiration takes place or respiration occurs through certain organs we call respiratory system. Though gaseous exchange and the breakdown of energy from glucose or the body nutrients takes place inside the cell, in general, in plants, the respiration takes place throughout the body, whereas in plants, respiration is confined to respiratory organs. Now the second difference in plants, when compared to animals, the transport of respiratory gases are very less, very negligible. Transport of respiratory gas, because every cell of the body can perform respiration in plants. So respiratory gases do not get transported as profusely as in animals. Animals need more energy, so more exchange and the transport of respiratory gases takes place. Okay, that's the answer for this first question. Now the second question is, what is lymph? Write its important function. Lymph is light yellow colored fluid that drains from the capillaries into the extracellular medium, extra tissue medium. So the lymph is also called extracellular fluid. They are filled in between interstitial fluid. They are also called interstitial fluid or extracellular fluid, as they fill in the space between the cells. That's why they are called extracellular fluid. And they drains from the capillaries. When the blood flows through the capillaries, the blood gets filtered, and they are light yellow colored connective tissue. Light yellow colored connective tissue. Okay, they contain less amount of RBC platelets, RBC blood cells and proteins. The main function of the lymph is to carry the digested food from our digestive tract. They carry the digested food from the digestive tract and deliver to the lymphatic vessels, which in turn carry the fat. Lymphatic vessels or lymphatic capillaries carry the blood containing fat into various organs for the storage. So mainly lymph carry the digested fat from the the digestive tract by the lymphatic capillaries and vessels for the further storage. Right. Now third question, why scrotum remain outside the body of human beings? Yes. We know the scrotum always hangs from the abdominal cavity because the scrotum maintain a comparatively low temperature, that is 1 to 3 degrees Celsius less or lower than the body temperature. This facilitates the formation of sperms inside the testis. So why is scrotum is separated or hangs from the abdominal cavity? Yes. Scrotum provides a comparatively low temperature in the testis. That is 1 to 3 degrees Celsius less as compared to the other you know, normal body temperature. This facilitates the formation of sperms. Now, fourth one. Give reason why some plants are propagated by vegetative method. Of course, you know. Some plants like sugarcane, you know, that pineapple, rose, hibiscus, and many other types of plants do not produce viable seeds through sexual reproduction. Though sexual reproduction takes place in them, but they did not, or they do not come into the formation of, results in the formation of viable seeds. So such plants which do not produce viable seeds through sexual reproduction are propagated by vegetative methods. Okay? Right. Now the last question, why are acquired characters not inherited? Acquired characters, for example, change in the skin color, then change in our body hair color, okay, and many other characters are called somatic characters, as they do not make any change in the germ cell, DNA of the germ cells, they cannot be inherited. Okay, these traits which develop during the lifetime of an organism is called acquired character, and that only make changes in the somatic body or somatic body parts and do not make changes in the DNA of germ cells. Hence, they are not inherited. That's all. Thank you.